There was nine and nine horsemen rode through Bancree fair, and bonny Glenlogie was the plough o' there. And bonny Glenlogie was the plough o' there. There was nine and nine ladies sat in the Queen's dine, and bonny Jeanie o' Bethelny was the plough o' twice nine. And bonny Jeanie o' Bethelny was the plough o' twice nine. She has collied his footboy that walked by his side, saying, "Who is your master and where does he bide?" Saying, "Who is your master and where does he bide?" He is stylied Glenlogie when he is at home, but he's of the noble Gordons and his name is Lord John. But he's of the noble Gordons and his name is Lord John. Glenlogie, Glenlogie, if he will prove kind, a maiden's lovelied on you, must she die in her prime? A maiden's lovelied on you, must she die in her prime? He's turned about lechtly as Gordon's dee, my thanks, Lady Jean, my love's promised awa. My thanks, Lady Jean, my love's promised awa. She has called her father's chaplain, a man of great skill, and he has wrote a letter and indited it well. And he has wrote a letter and indited it well. When Glenlogie got the letter, a lechtlach gid he, but ere he read it over, a tear dimmed his ee. But ere he read it over, a tear dimmed his ee. "Go saddle my black horse and bring it to the green." But ere they had it ready, he was 2 mile hem lean. But ere they had it ready, he was 2 mile hem lean. Pale and wan was she when Glenlogie gied him, but red and rosy grew she when she kent it was him. But red and rosy grew she when she kent it was him.
Three gypsies came to our hall door, and oh, but they sang bonny, oh. They sang so sweet and to complete that to stall the heart of our lady, oh. For she come tripping down the stairs, her maidens to be for a row, and when they saw her wheel but face, they throwed their spell out her row. When her good lord came home that night, he was asking for his lady, oh. But the answers the servants gave to him, "She's awa with the gypsy laddies, oh." "The saddle to me, my bonny, bonny black, my brunette's mercy speed yo, that I may go riding this long summer day in a search of my true lady. But it's here out east and here out west and here out through Strathbogie, oh, and there he met a gay old man that was coming through Strathbogie. For it's dead ye come east, or dead ye come west, or dead ye come through Strathbogie, oh, and dead ye see a gay lady, she was falling three gypsy laddies, oh. For it's I've come east and I've come west and I've come through Strathbogie, oh, and the bonniest lady that e'er I saw, she was falling three gypsy laddies, oh. For the very last night that I crossed this river, I had dukes and lords to attend me, oh. But this night I must put on my warm feet and wait, and the gypsies waiting before me, oh. Last night I lay in a good feather bed, my own wedded lord beside me, oh. But this night I must fly in a cow corn barn, and the gypsies lying around me, oh. For it's well you give up your houses and your lands, and well you give up your baby, oh, and it's well you give up your own wedded glory and keep following the gypsy laddies, oh. For it's I'll give up my houses and my lands, and I'll give up my baby, oh, and it's I'll give up my own wedded glory and keep following the gypsy laddies, oh. For there are seven brothers, all we all are wondrous bonny, oh. But this very night we all shall be hanged for the stealing of the Earl's lady.
Come saddle to me, my all grey mare, Come saddle to me my pony, you, and I'll take the road and I'll go far away after my roving ploughboy, you. Ploughboy, you, ploughboy, you. I'll follow the roving ploughboy, you. Last night I lay on the fine feather bed, sheets and blankets a cosy, oh. This night I'm in lie on a cold barn shed, wrapped in the arms of my ploughboy, oh. Ploughboy, oh, ploughboy, oh. I'll follow the roving ploughboy, oh. A champion ploughman, majority, oh. Caps and medals and prizes, oh. On Bonnie Devran's side, there are none to compare with my jolly roving ploughboy, oh. Ploughboy, oh, ploughboy, oh. I'll follow the roving ploughboy, oh. So fare ye well, Dale Huntly Doon, fare ye well, Drumdelgie, oh, for now I'm on the road and I'm going far away after my roving ploughboy, oh. Ploughboy, oh, ploughboy, oh. I'll follow my roving ploughboy, oh.
Oh, where are you going, said the false knight upon the road. I'm going to the school, said the wee boy, and still he stood. What's that upon your back, said the false knight upon the road. My bonnet and my book, said the wee boy, and still he stood. If I had you at the sea, said the false knight upon the road, and a good ship under me, said the wee boy, and still he stood. If I had you at the well, said the false knight upon the road, and you into hell, said the wee boy, and still he stood.
What's that on your back, cried the false knight upon the road. Here it's the bundles and my book, cried the wee lad, and still he stood. Oh, will you give me share, cried the false knight upon the road. Oh, what can ye gie share, cries the wee boy, and still he stood. Oh, what no sheep and cattle is that, cried the false knight upon the road. Sure it's my father's new and mine, cried the wee boy, and still he stood.
What's upon your back, said the false knight upon the road. My bonnets and my book, said the wee boy, and still he stood.
He took the first one by the hand, turned her round and made her stand, turned her round and made her stand on the bonny, bonny banks afore Dee, oh. Oh, will you be a robber's wife, or will you die by my penknife? Will you die by my penknife on the bonny, bonny banks afore Dee, oh? Oh, I'll not be a robber's wife, nor will I die by your penknife, nor will I die by your penknife on the bonny, bonny banks afore Dee, oh. He took the second one by the hand, turned her round and made her stand, turned her round and made her stand on the bonny, bonny banks afore Dee, oh. Will you be a robber's wife, or will you die by my penknife? Will you die by my penknife on the bonny, bonny banks afore Dee, oh?
Two pretty boys were going to the school, and one evening coming home, said William to John, can you throw a stone? Or can you play at a ball? Or can you play at a ball? Said William to John, I cannot throw a stone, nor little can I play at a ball. But if you come down to yon merry green wood, I'll try a wrestling fall. I'll try a wrestling fall. So they come down to yon merry green wood, beneath the spreading moon, and the little penknife slipped out of William's pocket and gave John his deadly wound, and gave John his deadly wound. Oh, you take off your white Holland shirt and tear it for gore to gore, and you will bind my deadly wounds, and they will bleed no more, and they will bleed no more. So he took off his white Holland shirt, and he tore it for gore to gore, and he did bind his deadly wounds, but they bled 10 times more and more, but they bled 10 times more. Oh, what will I tell to your sister dear this night when I go home? You can tell her I'm away to London school, and the good books I'll bring home, and the good books I'll bring home. And what will I tell to your brother dear this night when I go home? You can tell him I'm away to a London school, and the good scholar I'll come home, and the good scholar I'll come home. And what will I tell to your sweetheart dear this night when I go home? You can tell her I'm dead and in graves laid, and the grass is growing green, and the grass is growing green. And what will I tell to your father dear this night when I go home? You can tell him I'm dead and in graves laid, and the grass is growing green, and the grass is growing green. And what will I tell to your stepmother dear tell her I'm dead and in graves laid. For she prayed I might never come home. She prayed I might never come home.
Lady Margaret, Lady Margaret, been sewing at a sink. She look at it, she look at west, and she saw those merry green wood growing green. She saw those merry green woods, but she kilted up her petticoats. It's up to them she ran, and when she came to those merry green woods, she pulled the branches down, my dear. She pulled those branches down. For there she spied a gentleman coming through the to her side. Oh, I shall give you all leave, my dear, to pull those branches down, my dear. I shall give you all leave, but it's once I could pull those trees. It's once I could pull those trees. It's once I could pull those trees. Those trees, all a thousand leave of you, my dear. All a thousand leave of you. But he catched her by the middle small. He gently laid her down. Since you've got your will of me, come tell to me your name, kind sir. Come tell to me your name, for tomorrow is New Halloween, and the quality's going to ride. You'll pass them by at the old mill as he go riding by, my dear. As he go riding by, for the first will be is a white milk steed, and that's then will be a black. You'll hold his head, you'll be not ill. He's the father of your child, my dear. He's the father of your child. For the next will be so large, you'll
hold his head. You'll feem not ill, he's a father of you, child. My dear, he's a father of you, child. For the nest will be as unto a naked man. You'll throw your mantle all around and cry, you're one, my dear, you're one. You're the father of my child.
Oh, for the sea may run dry and the fishes fly and the rocks melt with the sun. And if ever I prove false unto you, it's my heart's blood it may run, my dear. It's my heart's blood it may run. When I am on the sea, oh, pray think of me. When I'm far on the foreign shore, for it's hold me fast, forget me not. I'm the father of your child, my dear. I'm the father of your child. For the very first thing that you may turn me into, may it be a lion so fierce. But hold me fast and fear me not. I'm one of God's unmake, my dear. I am one of God's unmake.
I'm a forester in this wood, and you're the same design. It is a mantle, oh, your maiden, he bonny lassie, never mind. Sing in the D.I.O., sing fall-a-do, sing the D.I.O., aye. Sign you've let me doon, it's come pick me up again. And sign you've teen the walls of me, come tell to me your name. Sing in the D.I.O., sing fall-a-do, sing the D.I.O., aye. Sometimes they call me James, and sometimes they call me John. And when I'm on the King's Highway, young Daniel is my name. Sing in the D.I.O., sing fall-a-do, sing the D.I.O., aye. They neither called you James, or they neither called you John. And when you're on the King's Highway, young William is your name. Sing in the D.I.O., sing fall-a-do, sing the D.I.O., aye. When he heard his name called out, he's mounted on his steed. She's buckled up her petticoats, and after him she's gied. Sing in the D.I.O., sing fall-a-do, sing the D.I.O., aye. He's run and she run the long summer day, till they come to the water, it was cried the river day. Sing in the D.I.O., sing fall-a-do, sing the D.I.O., aye. It's day you see yon castle, it's o'er yonder green. There is the bonniest maiden there that would dazzle your een. Sing in the D.I.O., sing fall-a-do, sing the D.I.O., aye. I see the castle, it's o'er yonder green, and I have seen the maiden there that would dazzle your een. Sing in the D.I.O., sing fall-a-do, sing the D.I.O., aye. Did he steal their mantle, or did he steal their fee? Or did he steal their maidenhead, the floor of your body? Sing in the D.I.O., sing fall-a-do, sing the D.I.O., aye. He neither stole my mantle, or he neither stole my fee. But he stole my maidenhead, the floor of my body. Sing in the D.I.O., sing fall-a-do, sing the D.I.O., aye. I wished a drunk of water, the night a drunk of wine, to hae a shepherd's daughter, to be a love of mine. Sing in the D.I.O., sing fall-a-do, sing the D.I.O., aye. When the marriage had come off, they laughed to see the fun. She was the laird of Yuri's daughter, he was a blacksmith's son. Sing in the D.I.O., sing fall-a-do, sing the D.I.O., aye.
A peddler busk and a peddler thrum and a peddler linking over the lee. To there he met with two troublesome men he was seems to be. What's in your pack now, my guy filly? What's in your pack now, come tell to me. There's seven shirts and three cravats beside my bowstrings, two or three. It be my soul, says little John, the most part of that shall fall to me. The peddler takes the pack now off his back and lays down low by his knee. Any man that'll fight me three steps back, the pack and I shall fall to thee. Little John drew a broad, broad bran, and the peddler drew the same. To the bodged swagged swords, to the bodged sweet, crying, noble peddler, hold your hand. It's what's your name, no my gay filly, what's your name, no come tell to me. Then at a better my name shall tell, to both your names you shall tell to me. And it lies on my ain breeze bone, whether I'll tell my name or no. But my name it was Stoutfully, I was putting far now across the sea. For the killing of man and my father's land, to the merry green woods I was forced to flee.
Dear sister, would you take my hand? He who answered bonny and put your foot on that marble stone, and this one's warm, Sabonio. Dear sister, would you go walk with me? Hey, ho, once upon you, and I will show you wonders before you return, and once warm upon you. For the worries two sisters left in a mill. Hey, oh, handsome bonio. For the youngest sister pushed the oldest sister in, and was drowned in the dams of Benorio. Oh, my lord, come stop your dam. Hey, oh, and Sabonio. For I do see a maiden, a white milk's one, and this one's warm and benorio. For the malari he stand, he stopped up his dam. Hey, oh, and shabboni, oh. And it's then they took her and hung her up to dry, and swan how is woman benorio. For there were his three fiddlers passing this way. Hey, ho, and sabonio. There was one of them tin her for a finger, for to make a fiddle pan. And another of them ten three lengths of her yellow hair, for it to make some fiddle strings. And the other of them ten her breastbone, for it to make a fiddle that would play a tune at Sloan. And this one, how swam and benorio.
A bigger, a bigger, come o'er the lee. He was asking lodgings for charity. He was asking lodgings for charity. Would you loo a bigger man? Oh, lassie, we bet out ouri. A bigger, I'll never loo again. I had a doctor and she was her name. I had a daughter and she was her name. She's run about with the bigger man. Oh, laddie, we met our hourie. I'll bend my back and I'll bow my knee. I'll put a black patch over my ear. And a bigger, they'll take me to be. And a wawee, you all gang, oh, laddie, we met our hourie. Oh, lassie, you're far too young. And you henny got the cant, oh, the big and tongue. Yeah, and he got the canto, the big and tongue. And with me, yeah, when he gang, oh, lassie, we met our hourie. She's bent her back, and she put her knee. And she's put a black patch over her ee. And she's kilted her skirts up abin her knee. And away him she's gone, oh, laddie, we met our hourie. Your daughter Jean's coming o'er the lee. She's taken him her bairnies tree. She is yin on her back, aye, and there on her knee. And the other yin stoodlin' him, oh, lassie, we met our hourie.
The brown girl has got houses and lands. Fair Ellen, she hasn't got none. And if you take your mother's advice, you would bring the brown girl home. He dressed himself in scarlet red, All mounted door with green, and every town that he rode through, they thought he was some king. When he came to Fair Ellen's gates, how loudly he rang the bell. There were none so ready as Fair Ellen to welcome Lord Thomas in. What news, Lord Thomas, she cried. What news have you brought to me? I've come to bid you to my wedding, and that's sad news to thee. Forbid, Lord Thomas, she cried. Forbid it not to me, for I thought you the jolly bridegroom, and I the bride to be. Come, rattle me, mother, she cried. Come, rattle me all into one. Will I go to Lord Thomas Whedon, or will I stay at home? Many one's been your friend, Fair Ellen, and many one's been your foe. But if you take your mother's advice to Lord Thomas Whedon, don't go. When she came to Lord Thomas' gates, how loudly she rang the bell. There were none so ready as Lord Thomas to welcome Fair Ellen. Is this your bride, Lord Thomas, she cried. Is this your bride, cried she. For I thought you the jolly bridegroom, and I the bride to be. Despise her not, Fair Ellen, he cried. Despise her not to me. I wouldn't give your little finger for all her whole body.
Come rattle me, tattle me, mother, he said, come rattle me all into one. Or shall I go and wed Fair Ellen, or welcome the brown girl home? To the brown girl she having houses and land, Fair Ellen she having got none. So if you'll take your mother's advice, do welcome the brown girl home. He's dressed himself in scarlets of red, ornaments of yellow and green. And every town that he rode through, they thought he was a king. And when he came to Fair Helen's gates, out loudly he rang the rill. And who was there more gladder than she to welcome Lord Thomas in? What is the matter, Lord Thomas, she cried. Oh, what is the matter, quoth she. I've come to bid ye take my wedding, such news do I bring to thee. Forbid, forbid, Lord Thomas, she cried. Forbid, forbid, quoth she. For I thought that he was to be my own bridegroom, and me your bride to be. Come rattle me, mother, she said, come rattle me all into one. Or shall I go to Lord Thomas's wedding, or shall I stay at home? Oh, many has been your friend, dear Ellen, and many has been your foe. He's ruined your life, and he'll prove your death, till Lord Thomas's wedding don't go.
And then at the wedding, what happens then, Willie?
Oh, well, at the wedding, the brown girl stabbed Fair Ellen, and he cut the hair of his own bride off, and he dashed it against the wall, and it finishes up by saying that these three lovers, they died together, and every one proved true. Now these three lovers, they died together, and every one proved true.
Johnston and the young colonel were drinking Hyatt wine. If you will marry my sister, then I will marry thine. Oh, no, no, said the young colonel, such a thing shall never be. I'll keep her as my housekeeper when I come o'er the lea. Now Johnston had his gay broadsword, and a gay broadsword had he. He reared it through the young colonel till a word he ne'er spoke more. Then he spurred his steed and swift he ran, like lightning o'er the lea, till he did come to his sister's gate, and he tinkled at the pen. I dreamt a dream, brother dear Johnston, and I hope it's for your good. They are seeking you with hound and hawk, and the young colonel is dead. They are seeking me with hound and hawk, as I well expect they'll be. And I have killed the young colonel, your own true lover was he. Be gone, you bloody knight, get ye be gone from me. If ye have killed the young colonel, you'll be no brother to me. He spurred his steed and swift he ran, like lightning o'er the lea, till he did come to his sweetheart's gate, and he tinkled at the pin. I dreamt a dream, love dear Johnston, I hope it's for your good. They are seeking you with hound and hawk, and the young colonel is dead. They are seeking me with hound and hawk, as I well expect they'll be. And I have killed the young colonel, your own dear brother was he. Come in, love dear Johnston, come in and take a rest. I care no more for the young colonel if your own dear body is safe. He was scarcely landed up the stairs into the tower above, when 24 stout-belted knights came seeking him at the gate. Oh, did you see a bloody knight? And a bloody knight was he. Oh, did you see a bloody knight ride furiously o'er the lea? A light, ye gentlemen, and have some bread and wine. If the steed be good he rides upon, he's across the bridge of Tyne. Oh, thank you, lady, for your bread, and thank you for your wine. But I'd rather than thrice 100 pounds that your fair body was mine. Now Johnston had his gay broadsword, and a gay broadsword had he. He reared it through the lady's heart till she dropped it on the floor. What ails ye now, love, dear Johnston? What ails ye now, what me? Haven't I given you all my father's land besides my mother's fee? Oh, live, Lady Margaret, he cried. Oh, live her 1/2 hour. How can I live when my very heart's blood is trickling on the floor? Now Johnston had his gay broadsword, and a gay broadsword had he. He reared it through his own false heart. I've forgotten the last wee bit, but I know the end. They were supposed to be lying together on the floor dead. But it was true. It was really a true ballad. Mm-hmm. Well, it was usually when they said they were true in these old times, they were true. He was jealous of her, you see. He was at this type. You would have to understand the Johnstons to ken that type of person.
Lord Beauchamp was a noble lord, a noble lord of high degree. He set his ships upon the ocean, some foreign country he would go see. He sailed east and he sailed west until he came to Turkey. There he was taken and put in prison until his life was a misery.
This girl came to his big domains, his house, a big house, and she met in with his herd boy. And she says to the herd boy, who owns all those flocks of sheep? Who owns all those herds of kine? Who owns all those wealthy towers? And many more as I pass by. Then the boy says, Lord Bateman owns all those flocks of sheep. Lord Bateman owns all those herds of kine. Lord Bateman owns all those richly towers, and many more as you'll pass by. So she put her hand all into her pocket. She drew out sovereigns, they were 3. Take you this, my little herd boy, for that good tidings you've brought to me. She put her hand all into her pocket. She pulled out sovereigns and they were 3. Oh, take you this, my little herd boy, for this good tidings you've gave to me. So she left the boy and she went up to his castle. And she rang the bell. So the page boy came to her. And she says to the page boy, to tell his master to send out one slice of his wedding cake and one glass of his wedding wine, and to ne'er forget on a fair young lady that once released him from close confine. So the page boy ran up the stair, and Lord Bateman says to him, what news, my little page boy? When you kneel so low down upon your knee, out speaks his young bride's mother, and oh, what an angry woman was she. You'll have to wed my youngest daughter, although Susan Pirates came o'er the sea.
Maisie, she went up the street some fresh fish ball to buy, and the waiton clerk, he heard her feet, and he pulled her on the sly. Rick-a-doo-dum-dee, doo-dum-dee, rick-a-dick-a-doo-dum-dee. Wait, why will I get to your bed, my love? Wait, why will I get to your bed? My mother, she locks the door at night, and the key lies under her head. Rick-a-doo-dum-dee, doo-dum-dee, rick-a-dick-a-doo-dum-dee. If you'd get a ladder along, some 60 steps and three, and way along rope to the chimney top, and you'll come in a creel to me. Rick-a-doo-dum-dee, doo-dum-dee, rick-a-dick-a-doo-dum-dee. It's no, he's got a ladder along, some 60 steps and three, and way along rope to the chimney top, and he's coming a creel to be. Rick-a-doo-dum-dee, doo-dum-dee, rick-a-dick-a-doo-dum-dee. Nae peace nor rest could they always get, strange things come in her head. I'll wager my life, says a silly old wife, there's a man in my doctor's bower. Rick-a-doo-dum-dee, doo-dum-dee, rick-a-dick-a-doo-dum-dee. The old man rose but on his clothes to see if this was true, but you got the Bible in her hand, and then the curtains drew. Rick-a-doo-dum-dee, doo-dum-dee, rick-a-dick-a-doo-dum-dee. Oh, father dear, but why you're up so late? For my mother, she rocks in bed at night, and the key lies under her head. Rick-a-doo-dum-dee, doo-dum-dee, rick-a-dick-a-doo-dum-dee. You silly old wife, you lying old wife, and an ill death may you die. But your doctor's lying in her bed, and she's praying for you and me. Rick-a-doo-dum-dee, roo-dum-dee, rick-a-dick-a-doo-dum-dee. The old wife, she rose and put on her clothes to see if this was true, but you caught her fit in the tumbling block, and into the creel she flew. Rick-a-doo-dum-dee, doo-dum-dee, rick-a-dick-a-doo-dum-dee. Them it was at the chimney top, they thought it was nothing new, but they thought it was the waiton clerks up the creel they drew. Rick-a-doo-dum-dee, doo-dum-dee, ah, rick-a-doo-dum-dee. But when they saw it was the old wife, they let the creel down far, and every rabbit they always bark, bed knick-knack on the wall. Rick-a-doo-dum-dee, doo-dum-dee, rick-a-dick-a-doo-dum-dee. It's so the blue, the bonny, bonny blue, the blue that I'll will. Let elke away be jealous or doctor, but rocket in the same old creel. Rick-a-doo-dum-dee, doo-dum-dee, ah, oh, rick-a-doo-dum-dee.
Well, I stood at the stable door, a leaning over his steed, a looking at his white fingers till his nose began to bleed. Oh, bring some corn to my horse and gie my young man meat, and I'll have at him Maggie's bower, I'll be there afore she sleeps. Oh, willy, dinna gang, it's here against my will. You've the deepest spot in the Clyde to cross, and it's there that he will drown. The horse that I'm to ride upon cost me twice £30. And I'll but trust in my own horse heels, and he'll carry me safe and soon. So he rid o'er hills and rid doon dales and doon yon dowie den. But the rush that rose in Clyde's water would have feared 100 men. Oh, Clydey, Clydey, rollin' Clyde, your waves are wondrous strong. Mak me a wreck as I come back, but spare me as I gang. Oh, Maggie, 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 dear, oh, rise and let me in. For my boots are full of Clyde's water, and I'm shivering to the skin. My stables are full of horses, my sheds are full of hay. My beds are full of gentlemen that winna meave till day. Maggie wakened in the morning, and to her mother she ran. Says, I dreamed that Willie was here last night, and I wouldna let him in. So he rid o'er hills, and he rid doon dales, and doon yon dowie den. But the rush that rose in Clyde's water took Willie's cane fae him. Leaning o'er his saddle bows to catch his cane through force, the rush that rose in Clyde's water took Willie fae his horse. Willie's brother stands on the bank, now how can Willie droon? Oh, turn ye to your high horse heed, and he'll learn ye how to swim.
So who is that at my window, so fain he would be in? 'Tis your own true lover, Willie, dear, frae Scotland he has came. "I hae nae lover there," out she cried, "I hae nae lover but een. It's the ae true love that I dae hae was here late this treen. So well, fare ye well then, false Maggie, sins better canna be. Oh, I'll awa the road I come, nae mair come thee to see. His brother stands upon yonder banks, says, fae man well ye droon. So turn ye round your high horse heed, and learn how to swim. Oh, why could I turn to my high horse head and learn how to swim? It's the deepest spot in the Clyde, and here that I'm undroon. Oh, mother dear, come read my drowsy dream. I dreamt sweet Willie was at my gates, nae him in. So lie still, my Maggie dear, lie still and take your rest. Since your true love was at your gates, 'tis full 3/4 past. But it's Maggie rose put on her clothes, and to the Clyde she went. The first step new that she took in, it took her to the knee. The next step new that she took in, it took her to the chin. And the deepest spot in the Clyde, she found her Willie in. So you have got a cruel mother, and I have got another. But here we lie in Clyde water,
like sister and like brother.
Young Hugh, he was the best of all, went out to kick the playboy's ball. He kicked that ball so very high, he clenched it with his knee. And at the back of some winding wall, young Hugh, he caused his ball to flee. Fling out my ball, fair maiden, he cried, fling out my playboy's ball. I dare not fling out your ball, young Hugh, it's till you came and talked to me. I dare not came, I cannot came, fling out my playboy's ball. For she pulled an apple both red and green off her father's garden wall, to welcome bonny young Hughie in. She welcomed him into one bedroom, and she welcomed him into two, and she welcomed him into her own bedroom, where many a duke and earl had dined. Her little penknife been long and sharp, she bid him take a sleep, and she wrapped him up on the cake of bleed, and put him into yonder wall, which 50 fathoms deep. And at the back is some winding wall, it's there is my young Hugh shall sleep. When cockle shells grow silver bells, it's there in me and young Hugh shall meet.
Mary, to the yow box again, to milk our daddy's yows. And aye, as she sang, her bonny visit rung right over the tops of the nose. Nose right over the tops of the nose. There came a gentleman and he grinning by, milk on, my bonny, bonny lass, milk on, cried he. Milk on, my bonny, bonny lass, and show me over the lee, and show me over the lee. Ride on, kind sir, she said, ride on, cried she. Your steed is so strong, it'll carry you along, it'll carry you over the lee. Lee, it'll carry over the lee. He took her by the lily white hand and by the green dress sleeve, and he's laid her down upon the dewy, dewy grass, and he's asked no man's leave. Leave, and he's asked no man's leave. She took her milk pails in her hand, and she come singing him, and aye as she sang, her bonny visit rung right over the tops of the nose. Now right over the tops of the nose.
War and what a hardenin' his sons, and guard them right, both the quarter side. Warn Gowdy Lins and Allen Howe, and Gilman's Cleugh and Common Side, as he passed the yet operist of Swire, warn the courier o' the lee, and as he come down the hermit reach lock, warn Doughty Willie o' Gorenberry.
On Miller Tefty lived a man, and the neighborhood of Ivy, and he had a hard love, he daughter fair, her name was Bonnie. Lord Fivey had a trumpeter, and his name was Andra Lamy, and he had the art to gain the heart of Bonnie Tefty.
Trumpeter, whose name was I.
rider to the door, saying, come here to me, my Annie. Did you see a prettier man than the trumpeter? Oh, but nothing she said, but a sigh and a sail. 'Twas a lass for Bonnie Annie, for she dares ne own that her heart was won by the trumpeter. And at a night when all went to their bed, I slept for sin, but Annie, love so oppressed her tender breast, and love will waste her body. Oh, love comes in to my bedside, and love will lie beyond me. Love so pressed my tender breast, and love will waste my body. My love, I go to Edinburgh town, and for a while, man, leave thee. Oh, but I'll be dead before ye come back in the green kirk yield, oh, fine. So her feather struck her wondrous soul, and also did her mother, and her sisters also took their score, but woe be to her brother. Her brother struck her wondrous soul with cruel strokes and many, and he broke her back out of the temple stain, aye, the temple stain, oh, fivey. Oh, mother dear, please make my bed, and lay my face to Fivey, for I will lie and I will die for my dear Anne. Now when Andra him feeding but I came, we muckle grief and sorrow, my love she died for me last night, so I'll die for her too.